Hi, Alex here. Nice to see you again. I'm excited today because we are answering the four most searched questions about sustainability on Google. This is the top four questions people have when they search sustainability on Google. What is the simple definition of sustainability? What are the three pillars of sustainability? Why is sustainability so important? And how can we achieve sustainability? Okay, let's answer the first question. Sustainability is the capacity of our human society to continue indefinitely within Earth's natural cycles. Then, a sustainable development is a development that leads towards sustainability. It makes sense so far, right? What are these natural cycles? In 1989, after many drafts, a group of 50 scientists agreed on a few key things about how Earth's natural cycles function. I explained all this in another video. You can click in the top right corner to watch it. The scientific consensus made it possible to look at the things that we, humans, do to interfere with these natural cycles. These are the four root causes of unsustainability. We extract large flows of materials from the Earth crust. We create an accumulation of substances produced by society. We physically inhibit nature's ability to run its cycles. And we create barriers to people meeting their basic needs worldwide. The first three speak to the environment, while the fourth one is more social. But I'm getting ahead of myself here. We will talk about this later when answering the question, how can we achieve sustainability? Okay, next question. Sustainability is often presented as having three pillars: economic, social, and environmental. This is also known as the triple bottom line, particularly when talking about sustainability and business. The concept is often described as three overlapping circles. Sustainability is typically defined as the place where economy, social realities, and environmental health overlap. But the scientific consensus we mentioned earlier tells us that, left to its own devices, the planet operates in a balanced way. Photosynthesis pays the bills. Without it, creation of structure from energy would not occur, and entropy could rule the day. Plant cells belong to the environment circle of the three pillars. If plant cells are the original creators of structure, then this is the circle on which everything else depends, or in which everything is embedded. Everything comes from nature at some point. Society, which is related to the social circle of the three pillars, exists within the environment. An economy is a byproduct of society. Instead of three overlapping circles, we have three nested circles, where the economy is a wholly owned subsidiary of the environment. To watch my longer video about the triple bottom line, you can click in the top right corner. If you're enjoying the video so far, make sure to hit the thumbs up and subscribe. Okay, next please. The third question is, why is sustainability so important? Being humans' capacity to survive within Earth's natural cycles, sustainability is important because it is the only alternative to human extinction. Here is a way to explain how important sustainability is in a good and useful way, using the metaphor of a funnel. On the one hand, the Earth's capacity to provide what we need is declining. On the other hand, the rate at which we consume resources and generate waste is going up. And that's not all. Governments are changing laws that are getting stricter. Trust between people is declining. Prices are going up. Growing inequality around the world results in more social tension. The world's population is growing, etc., etc. It looks like all these trends are converging, right? And we don't want to see what happens if or when they meet. It is as if we were going deeper into a funnel. The pressure is increasing over time, and we have less and less margin to maneuver. I have a video specifically on this funnel metaphor if you want to learn more. Okay, we're almost done. Fourth question. How can we achieve sustainability? That's a good one. Achieving sustainability is essentially about meeting human needs within ecological constraints. Using the metaphor of the funnel, sustainability can be achieved by opening the walls of the funnel to create a resilient, fulfilling, and accessible society that can thrive within nature's limits. From a more scientific perspective, sustainability can be achieved by stopping our contribution to the four root causes of unsustainability we mentioned earlier. In other words, to become a sustainable society, we must eliminate our contributions to the systematic increase of concentrations of substances extracted from the Earth's crust, for example, heavy metals and fossil fuels, the systematic increase of concentrations of substances produced by society, for example, plastics, PCBs, and DDT, the systematic physical degradation of nature and natural processes, for example, over-harvesting forests, destroying habitat, and overfishing, and conditions that systematically undermine people's capacity to meet their basic human needs, for example, unsafe working conditions and not enough pay to live on. There is also a video explaining these principles in more details. You can click in the top right corner again. Et voilà, you just saved 2 hours searching these questions and answers on Google. Was that helpful? Please let me know in the comments down below. And also, what is the question about sustainability that you would search on Google? If you feel like you got some value out of this video, please like it, subscribe, and hit the bell to be notified when we post new videos. If sustainability is important to you, please consider becoming a patron to support our work. Thank you to all our patrons, and see you in the next video.